Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. It's Joffy Noodle Legs here today, doing another Noodle film review today. Today we're looking at John Carpenter's Christine. I remember seeing this back in the day and not being rather too impressed by it. I think it's because it was a Stephen King thing, and I'm not a big Stephen King fan, but I thought I'd revisit it now I'm, you know, a bit older, and I've not seen this for about, I don't know, 25, maybe 30 years. So I thought I'd give it a revisit. I picked this up in CEX. This version is on the indicator. It comes with a DVD and a Blu-ray disc and quite a few extra features. So I'll go through a little synopsis first for you. The film sort of starts off with in a sort of factory. And you see like the manufacturing line and all these sort of like really dull, dreary looking cars. And right in the middle is this red car, which is our Christine. Now, I can't show you little clips at the beginning because there's a lot of music being played. And obviously I don't want to get copyrighted. But it gets to a part where one of the guys is sort of looking at the cars and he ends up getting injured. So there we go. We see a little bit of the factory and the guy gets injured. Then we see this this old sort of black dude goes towards the car and he has a look and he sits in the car and he's not very nice. He's smoking a cigar and he sort of flicks his ash over the seat. And I don't think Christine likes it. And then the sort of shift ends and people start walking off. And one of the guys goes to inspect the car and finds that the black dude's been killed. Then we cut to like Haddonfield. It looks like Haddonfield again. And we meet our sort of two dudes. We meet the good looking guy and the nerdy looking guy. I think his name's Arnie. So we meet them for the first time.
Arnie, your lunch. And try and keep it cold. There's yogurt in there.
Right. So again, some of these clips, I have to be a bit careful and a bit quick because it goes into sort of music and stuff that's being played on the radio. So I've got to try not getting any of that in as I possibly can. So Arnie and his dude are having a chat in the car about Arnie needs to sort of like meet a nice lady friend.
Ratio of like 5 lousy points or
what, Arnie?
Fellatio. On a triple word score for 24 points in the game.
What'd she do?
She wouldn't let me have it. She won by 7 points because she said obscenity's not allowed in Scrabble.
Yeah.
And I looked it up and it's in the dictionary.
You're a jerk, Arnie.
You know, Arnie, I was thinking.
Uh-oh.
No, seriously. Now that we're going to be seniors, I figured it's about time that we got you laid. You know, like this year, huh?
Huh? I need a girl to get laid.
Well, what about Gail Justin, huh?
Oh, Gail Justin, yeah. Case? No, I don't like her mustache.
Fuck you, Arnie. I mean, what do you care if you get a little hair in your mouth, huh?
So then they go to their high school because they're high school students. Again, they're supposed to be around sort of like 16, 17, but they look a lot older than that. A bit like a prom night when they were supposed to be 6 years older from 10 and they all look like they're in their 20s. So then we see them and we meet a few more characters at the high school.
Hey, Gil, are you playing football this year or what?
Yeah, somebody's got to pick it up when you fumble.
Okay.
Hey, listen, how's your dopey knee?
Oh, it's better. Cliff wants me to practice.
Oh, yeah. Well, it's about time. I've been eating dirt with your name on it for the past 3 weeks.
Hi, Dennis.
Oh, hey, Roseanne. How you doing?
I'm okay. Are they gonna let you play football this year?
Oh, yeah. And Doc says I'm as good as new.
Then I guess I'll be seeing you out there.
I hope so.
Well, TTFN.
Yeah.
As you see, they've met a few of the characters there, and which is quite funny. And then we, and then the sort of like the girl that they all sort of like lust over sort of turns up at the school.
One heck of a good marching band went to the Rose Parade last year. Not a bad way to meet boys.
I would like to get involved with the yearbook.
Well, we have a terrific yearbook staff. We won a prize last year.
So, what do you think about admitting Red China into the UN?
If you already did that.
Yeah, but, do you think it was a good idea?
She smiled at me. I want to have deep, meaningful sex with her.
Go get her, Venus.
Then we cut a bit later into the day. At the high school, and he's looking for Arnie, and that's one of his friends says, yeah, he's down in this sort of like garage area where he's getting sort of bullied by these other kids, so he goes down to sort of help out.
Take an Arnie and let's go eat.
Yeah, that's all you gotta do. Come on. Come on. Come on.
That's funny, buddy. Real funny.
So he's gone down to sort of help out with Arnie, so then Arnie feels a little bit braver, and then it sort of kicks off a little bit. Then one of the teachers intervenes and says to him, well, look, to the the bad kid, you know, empty your pockets and sort of thing, you know, or we're going to get the police to come and they'll do it. And he empties his pocket and he sort of like finds the knife on him.
Go to the office, buddy.
I'll fix you. You're gonna wish you were never fucking born.
And then after them, we then cut back to Arnie and his buddy on their way home from high school.
I think Rupert isn't trying to get even. Nah, he's a douchebag. Find somebody else to pick on.
You kicked him out, you know.
Good. They kicked Mucci out?
Probation.
Those assholes.
So they continue having a bit of jibber jabber all the way, sort of like driving in their car. And then Arnie spots something out the corner of his eye, like some sort of old rusty old car. So he tells the other guy to, you know, go back. I want to see that car.
What is it, huh? You know someone who lives here?
So then we see the car for the first time, looking a bit worse for wears. and it's for sale, and Arnie really wants to buy it from the old boy.
I mean, whatever it is, it's not enough.
Jesus, Arnie.
Johnny, you ever owned a car before?
Yeah, he owns a Mustang.
No, I just got my license.
Name is George LeBay.
Arnie Cunningham. What are you asking?
Start her up.
Really?
Her name is Christine.
I like that.
So, there we go, and the old boy seems to be dressed in some sort of bondage gear there. I don't know what's going on there, but yeah, he's wearing some sort of corset or whatever. But I recognise him from a few things. If you know what he's been in, let me know down below, because I recognise him, and I can't place where he's from. I'm sure he was in something like Home Alone, I'm not sure. But let me know down below if you can recognise where he's from. Anyway, Arnie decides to buy the car.
It's easy for you to say. You already have a car.
Arnie, it's screwing you, man. You could get a really decent car for that kind of money. Come on.
Christine is decent.
Guy's weird, Arnie. It's fucking weird.
So, that was 300?
Yeah, that's it. Is that 250?
250 we do it. Arnie, man, if this is such a good idea, huh? Let's just come back tomorrow.
Do you realize she's 20 years old? I mean, that makes her officially an antique.
Great.
So he buys the car, and then he sort of like, it still works considering the state it's in. And then he takes it home, and his parents are not happy.
Oh, boy.
Well, actually, you're wrong. I mean, I couldn't finance it, but buying it for cash is no problem at all. Of course, registering a car at 17 is something else again, and for that I do need your permission.
Arnie, you know how we do things. You could have consulted with us.
You know, I've consulted with you about every damn thing I've ever done. I mean, everything in this house is a committee meeting, and if it's something I want, then I get outvoted 2-1. Well, this is no committee meeting. I bought the car, and that's it.
It most certainly is not it.
So they tell him that he cannot keep that there. He shouldn't have bought it, and they're not going to register him for his license and all this jibber-jabber. And so he gets the ump and takes it, and he takes it to like a garage that does sort of storage, where he can sort of store the car.
It's a problem, huh? Could you hunt your horn for me? Christine's doesn't seem to work.
Sure.
Thank you.
And from here, this is where we meet the owner of the garage. I quite like him. He's quite funny.
You know, you sold him that piece of shit. You ought to be fucking ashamed of yourself.
I didn't sell it to him. I tried to talk him out of it.
You should have tried harder. That once. Fucking bastard killed himself in it.
So then the owner of the garage goes over to Arnie and sort of lays down the rules to him. He's quite a cool character, this guy.
Steph's got to keep their cars running so they can keep bread on the table. It's not for rich ass, snot nosed kids going to go dragging on the orange bell. I don't allow no smoking in here, neither. You want a butt, you go out in the junkyard.
Well, I don't smoke.
Don't interrupt me, Paul. Don't interrupt me. Don't get smart.
Sir?
Why?
Those men over there are smoking. Better tell them to stop.
You try to help your buddy right out of here, Chuck.
And then they drive back home. Obviously, he gives him his lift in his car back to his house. Now that Christine's in that garage. And it comes apparent that Arnie is already really attached to Christine.
Do
you're gonna be okay?
Yeah, I'm okay. No. You gotta find yourself some other charity besides me and Christine.
What is it about that car, huh?
Then we sort of cut to a bit later in the film, back to the garage where we see the owner of the garage and some of his friends talking about Christine as Arnie's already started to work on the car.
It's got fucking brand new windshield wipers. For a busted windshield.
Well, the boy does have good hands.
Good hands. Bad taste in cars. You know, Papa, you can't polish a turd.
And in a bit later on, we cut to the high school library where we got Arnie's friend and his other friends. They're in the library and Arnie's friend trying to show his moves towards the girl, you know what I mean, that they all seem to like. And sort of, it's a huge fail.
What are you reading?
History.
Oh. Pretty boring, huh?
Yeah.
Listen, do you like music?
Uh-huh.
What about dancing?
Yes.
You think maybe you might, want to go out dancing with me? Like, I don't know, maybe this Friday night after the game?
Sorry, I can't.
And as the story's moving along, we seem to see bits of Arnie sort of coming out, and he's starting to get a bit of an attitude and starting to turn into a little bit of an a-hole, to be honest. And we start to pick up on that, and his parents and his friends are all picking up on it too.
You're his best friend. What's going on?
I don't know. I mean, I hardly see him anymore.
Neither do we. Ever since he bought that car, he's been obsessed with it.
And then we cut to a bit later where his friend sort of breaks into the garage through the window to have a look at Christine. And he's trying to get a closer look and get into the car. So he's trying to get into the car, but what happens is he tries to open it and he sort of bangs the door to try and open it. And then the radio comes on in the car. So that's why I had to cut the clip short, because of the music. And it's coming, the 1950s song, you know, you keep a knocking but you can't come in. So the car sort of reacts, like when Arnie's in there, all these sort of 1950s love songs comes on and stuff like that. So it's the car's got a life of its own. And then we cut to, I suppose it's supposed to be a few days later, and the high school, and there's Arnie's friends playing football, American football, as he's a part of the team. And Arnie turns up in the car with the young lady that they've all been trying to date.
Okay.
So Arnie's friend looks a bit shocked to see Arnie there with the girl, and they start kissing and stuff like that. So Arnie's not such a dork after all, is he, really? I think this car's brought him out in an attitude. Anyway, he's distracted watching Arnie and the girl, and he gets a major injury, and he can't play American football, and he ends up in hospital. And that's all I'm going to tell you. So Christine seems to be taking over Arnie and making him like just want to be with the car all the time. And the car gets jealous. Other things happen in the film with the bullies, which I won't tell you because I don't want to spoil it. And obviously something's happened in the car with his girl as well. So I won't tell you because I don't want to spoil it. What do I think of the film? It's a really good film. I'm really glad I revisited it after all these years. I think maybe at the time when I first saw it, I was so into my sort of gory films. You know, I liked the gore then, because gore was like, I was young and gore was like new to me, and it's just like, there's not a lot of gore in this, although it's still quite a horrible tale. There was not a lot of gore, and like I said, I'm not a huge Stephen King fan. There was very few films that came out, Stephen King's, that I actually liked around this time. I liked Pet Sematary, and obviously I liked The Shining, and I liked Cujo. I thought that was quite good, Cujo. But I wasn't a huge fan of this, but I am now. I absolutely loved it. I think it was amazing. Really good film. The plus is the film. I love the transfer. It does hold some grain in some parts, but again, it's an old film and it's filmed on a certain film type. But it's got typical John Carpenter camera work, which I love. And the characters are very John Carpenter as well. He's a great storyteller, John Carpenter, because he builds, you get to know the characters, and you tend to find what characters you like and what you don't like. Same as Halloween, there's some characters you liked and some you don't. You know, he builds that tension up, and he did that with this film as well, more so. And especially with Arnie, because I liked Arnie at the beginning, but near the end of the film, I couldn't stand him. I thought, you know, yeah, I don't like you at all. You know, you're horrible. Anyway, and I quite liked that. That was really cool. Well directed, well acted, some good effects in there. There's some quite good twists and turns in the story, and I loved. The negative, again, I'm just going to be boring, guys. Yeah, I wish it was a bit more gory. Maybe a few more killings would have been really good. But there we go. I can't have everything. So I'm going to score this a awesome movie, and I'm going to give it an 8 out of 10. Really cool film. Really enjoyed it. I loved the soundtrack as well. I thought it was really good, especially the 1950s stuff. I loved that sort of bit with the car, where it was like the car is almost like a person and it talked to Arnie by its music on the radio. I quite like that. And there's some quite cool deaths in there as well. Watch it. It's a great film. Really good. Christine. John Carpenter's Christine, 8 out of 10. That's my review. Have any of you guys seen it? Let me know down below what you thought of it if you have. So when I first saw it, I was not too impressed with it. A bit like, I don't know if you know one of the channels of Horror Hands. He done a video this last week or so about films that he was umming and ahhing about, but actually turned out to be good. Well, this is my one, if you like. But when I first saw it, I wasn't too impressed. I think because, like I said, a lot of horror films were really gory back then, you know, and they were really sort of like, I've never been into cars, you know. I don't drive a car. I've never been into cars, and it's never been the thing that's appealed to me. So that was probably another thing that didn't really appeal to me, like a killer car. No, you're all right. But it's great. Now I'm a bit older, I can appreciate for what it is. And the fact that it's so of its time, and it's got that high school feel, it's got an 80s feel, it's got a 50s feel, and I just loved it all together. I just thought it was such a good film. Really, really enjoyed it, 8 out of 10. Guys, please check out some horror channels for me before your next video. Check out Horror Hands, check out The Horror Geek, check out Man V Film, check out RS Designs, check out I Am Isolor, check out Pizzawell, check out Sarah of Horror, and Horror of Charge. Please check these channels out, guys. They're all really, really cool. Until next time, you look after yourselves, look after one another, and I really hope I'll see you all soon.